Crazy.
Rolling.
Hello, Dave Larkin, Varsity Sports Network. Here at a historic night at Calvert Hall, Marc Amatucci has released his book, No Limits, and here are some major players in the book. Guys, please go around, introduce yourself, and what year?
I'm Marc Wilson, 1982 national champ.
Marc Kauffman, 82 national champ.
Pop Tubman, point guard, 1982 national champs.
Jeff Nattans, 1985. I wish I was 82, national champ.
Darryl Edwards, class of 81. I started a national champ.
Yeah.
Daddy Darryl, Daddy D.
Hey, he got my brick tippin'.
We've all seen Marc on the court during game. What's he like in practice, Monday through Tuesday through Thursday?
Tooch was always intense, man. I think he was a psychology teacher, so he always kind of tried to meet you, you know, kind of on the mental aspect of it. But he was good, man. He knew the game. He knew how to kind of motivate us individually. And, you know, he was a winner. You know, he worked hard. I thought he was a coach that still to this day I use a lot of the style that he implemented with us as far as intensity, hard work, togetherness. And just you know, passion about the game. So
yeah,
he was great on and off the court. I carry both all of that with me.
That's great stuff. Marc, I know you play football, so I know you're a tough guy. Was there ever a sign of
fucking pills right dope?
Was there ever a time, when you said I've had enough of this guy? I'm done.
Well, no. There was never a time because my passion was basketball. I love football and I went on to play college football and basketball, but you know what? I love Tooch. I love the guys. Fortunately for me, he was a father figure, which I love him, you know, for the rest of my life, because he means that much, you know, that much to me. And I think he meant the same to all of us, because he didn't treat me any different than he would treat Money Wilson or anybody else. We were all the same, and that was terrific. That's why we love him.
Can you give us a brief description of your journey to and through Calvert Hall and what Coach Tooch meant to you?
Calvert Hall was probably one of the best decisions that Marc Wilson and I made together. We had already decided that whatever school we went to, we were going to go together. And we came to Calvert Hall, and I think that's one of the best decisions that we made together. And as Marc Kauffman hinted to, Tooch has always been like a father figure, I think, to each and every one of us, individually, and at the same time, collectively. But he was just a great guy, man, and it was a pleasure playing for him and playing at Calvert Hall and playing with all my brothers, and it's just one of the best experiences of my entire life.
That's awesome.
That's awesome.
Jeff,
before you guys want to get the shoes in there,
That's Pop Tubman shoes,
pop
baby.
Shoes. What's it, Halloween?
You see the socks, bro. I see the reds.
You got a Cowboy socks.
Man.
What's
the matter?
You got
to
get my Gucci. Come up with Gucci's, right? You got Gucci?
No, Ferragamo.
Give it up for Jeff.
Not everybody can win a national championship. Give us a little bit of idea about your experience at Calvert Hall. And what Coach Tooch meant to you on and off the court?
Great. So I will say a couple things. First, I was in 7th and 8th grade and 9th grade when these guys were playing and the impact they had for Calvert Hall. So Tooch recruited me here, but I wanted to come here because of what these guys did on the court. So when I was in 7th and 8th grade, I would get home Friday nights. I couldn't wait for my mom to let me to come up here to watch them play. Right? The impact, the stands were always packed. The energy, the excitement. So I wanted to come to Calvert Hall because of these guys, right?
And then,
no, I did. So I wanted to come here because of what the atmosphere, what they did, how hard they played. And you knew for Coach Tooch, there were going to be life lessons, right? You got to work hard, right? Teamwork, right? Accountability. You needed to show up.
Right.
And the one thing I'll say about Tooch, there are a lot of corporate. So Tooch was my college coach. I never got to play for him at Calvert Hall.
Oh, cool.
I played for him at Loyola. But the one thing, Pop was my teammate at Loyola.
At Loyola.
So I will say this, the there are a lot of businesses now, right, spending a lot of money on this term diversity and inclusion. Tooch was ahead of the curve. Tooch didn't care if you were black, white, red. You know what he cared? You were going to jump in the foxhole and fight. Right, and you were gonna work hard. And he didn't care what you looked like.
You better bring the grades.
Right? So I can say, hey, Pop's one of my best friends. Pop is one of my best friends. And you know what? Didn't matter. But you know what? I love Pop because he's gonna work hard. And if you need him, he's gonna be there. And that's what it's all about.
Thanks. That's great stuff. Darryl, I know you had a great career here.
I'm gonna follow that up, Darryl Edwards.
It's hard to follow.
How does it feel to know that a guy like me, if I'd have been on the team that year, you might not have seen the court? Because I can box out.
Darryl would have jumped over you that year. Darryl was like a kangaroo.
Tell us a little about your experience at Calvert Hall.
No, it was a great experience. You know, like I said earlier, when I came to the hall, you know, they were rebuilding. And, Tooch talked to my mom and dad, especially my dad, and he was like, you know, we can make a difference if you come up to the hall. You know, your son can make a difference if he comes to the hall. And, you know, and I believed him. I believed him. And like all these guys said, you know, I trusted him. You know, I believed in what he said, and I trusted him. And then when I got here, and then, you know, all these guys came a year behind me, the only year behind me, you know, I knew we had something special. And we are just as close now as we were then.
36 years ago.
We can start seeing each other for years, and you would never know him.
My mother recruited his daughter to Clemson.
That's right. Mark recruited my daughter to Clemson.